to be John's.
All right, we have finally made it to Idaho. I would have filmed the drive. Not that it's super scenic or anything, but I was driving the whole time. And of course, you know, 1 week out from the wedding, I already ran into issues. Go figure. Nothing ever goes smoothly with wedding planning, but we are dealing with it. Anyway, here we are in Idaho, 5 hours later. Wyatt's checking in right now. I think PB's already in the lobby, so Josie and I are hanging out in the car. We're probably just gonna go get changed and then go to welcome drinks. So I plan to bring the camera along, probably take some pictures of Couer d'Alein, give you guys a reason to come out to Idaho. Yeah, heard nothing but great things about this place, so I'm excited to bring you guys along on the trip. Hello, Idaho. It's not really a lot to see, but enjoying a drink before we go to welcome drinks.
So, Alita,
oh, this lighting.
Yeah.
Wow. How can I bring this lighting to my YouTube studio? Hey.
What?
We're on the bus getting ready to go to the wedding, so I'll be sure to take you guys along for all that. Catch you guys in a little bit.
Hook him, baby.
He went to Clemson. Don't be fooled.
Yo, fuck Alabama. Great double position.
Lead the way, PB.
Sorry?
Lead the way.
Did you play too?
Yeah.
You didn't hit.
We had a good four.
It literally says Richard Dunn. That wraps up another trip. I know that one was a short one, but it certainly was a fun one. I guess I recorded most of the reception and the dancing. I didn't really catch a lot of earlier in the trip. And a lot of that has to do with, like, when I'm in social situations, I tend to be fully present in those moments and fully immersed in chatting with people and catching up with them. And it's really hard to film and have conversations at the same time. Coeur d'Alene is definitely somewhere I highly recommend. Like, if you like small lake town, it is not just like small town though. It is like luxury small town in Idaho. I love the fact that I don't think a lot of tourists know about this little gem in Idaho. So if you are catching on to this early now, definitely book yourself a trip before it becomes popular, because that town is just so beautiful. And I won't be surprised if people start discovering it and going out there and posting it on Instagram. And then next thing you know, everyone's booking summer trips to Coeur d'Alene. Maybe it actually is more popular than I know. A lot of our friends out here in Seattle, at least in the Pacific Northwest, know about Coeur d'Alene, but it's not. Maybe I just don't get targeted in a lot of tourist Coeur d'Alene stuff. I don't know. Either way, it is something I highly recommend that, you know, if you want to enjoy like a quiet lake weekend, but in a nice hotel or in a nice place, definitely look into booking a trip out there. Their welcome party was at the Coeur d'Alene Resort. So that view was phenomenal from that rooftop terrace. And then their wedding was at the Hayden Lake Country Club, which I think is members only. So that, unfortunately, unless you know somebody, you probably won't get to enjoy. I will say it was so cool getting to see the lake from different points of view. So that the whole trip, or the whole all the footage I got where we were on the water, was all the same lake. So it is a pretty big lake. There's a lot of homes on it. But yeah, if you guys can, and if you're lake people or you enjoy being by water, it reminds me a little bit of Lake Tahoe, but a lot less tourists. Definitely check out Coeur d'Alene. I'm hoping Wyatt and I can maybe do one more trip out there before, you know, we move to our next orders, because it's just so beautiful. And for granted, the weather just lined up so incredibly. I mean, it was the most breathtaking view for a wedding that literally I've ever seen. And I've been to so many weddings, and every wedding I've been to has been so phenomenal in its own way. I think every wedding, you know, has its strength, and this one was that backdrop for dinner. It was just so breathtaking. So I feel very lucky to have been a part of Tessa and Luke's big day. Hats off to fellow bride Tessa for planning a very beautiful wedding. I mean, the aesthetic was just so on point. I mean, I wish I could have filmed the ceremony, because like the way she had it set up was just also so picturesque and so beautiful. I mean, you guys can only imagine. You guys saw what was under that tent. It literally was Pinterest in real life. So hats off to Tessa. It was a beautiful, beautiful weekend. YouTubers, if you want to see more, I will be going to more weddings. Wyatt and I already have at least two that we know that we're invited to. Hopefully a third, maybe a fourth. We probably will have some in 2025. So I'm so excited to share with you our next travel adventures. What I have coming up next on YouTube will be a lot of wedding stuff. I will be spilling the tea on all things wedding planning. I mean, like, from the get-go, all the stuff I did, all the decor, all the vendors, things I would repeat, things I wouldn't repeat. So definitely stay tuned for that. If you are enjoying this content, hit that subscribe button. I would love if you would follow along on my journey. I've got so many fun things to share with you guys. And also follow along on Instagram. See, I post a lot of like outfits and products that I really like on Instagram. If you like things that I use, definitely follow me on Instagram. That's where you'll find links to products that I use. And then go ahead and like this video so I know what kind of content to push out there for you guys. I'm so glad that you guys were able to join, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!